Hello there. Today's video is on regression testing. Before we understand regression testing, let us understand regression. Regression means some kind of decay or deterioration in the system that we are using. Just to take a real life example, a regression can be, suppose you want air conditioning to be fitted in your house, and when the contractor fits the air conditioning, you find that the lighting system is off now. There is some problem with the lighting system. So that is an example of a regression, because earlier the lighting was working and now it is no longer working. In the case of software, we can take example of any email software. Let us say that there is a new feature of putting an attachment in an email. But once the new feature is included in the software, you find out that it is no longer possible to send any email, whether with or without an attachment. So that is another example of regression. So what is software regression? Software regression is any unwanted change that happens after changes are made to the system. Now, the system change can have some software code that is changed in order to implement new feature or to fix certain defects. Or it can be that some of the underlying components in the software change. For instance, the component being used for data access is upgraded, or there is a new database version, or there is a new browser version within which the software has to operate. Or it can even be some hardware change or networking change, and it can even be some user data change. For example, the user data type has changed. Instead of text, now the users are putting in both text and images, or the volume of the user data has changed. So all these changes can happen to the system. Software regression is any unwanted problems that occur after the system is changed in any way. Now, this decay in the software can be functional or non-functional. Functional regression means that there is loss of functionality what was working previously. Non-functional regression means that maybe the system is now much slower, or maybe it is less secure than before. Now, the next question is, what causes software regression? One of the more common causes of software regression is that the common code being used by the different software components is changed incorrectly. So whereas the component is working fine with one feature, it may not work fine with other features. Other cause of software regression can be incorrect version control. So software developers always put their code within a version control system. And if the version control is used incorrectly, it is possible to overwrite the changes made by someone else or overwrite the previous changes. So that can cause software regression. Another cause of software regression can be incorrect bug fixes. So the bug is fixed, but in an incorrect way, which causes unwanted problems. Or it can be incomplete bug fixes. The bug is fixed in some area, but not in each and every area that is required. And it can also be that the code is not updated according to the component changes. Maybe if the database version has changed. Mostly whenever the underlying components change, they are fully backward compatible, but not always. So it is possible that if the new database version is implemented, it may not work correctly with each of the existing features implemented in the software. Same thing with newer browser versions. Now, here the question is, what is regression testing? Well, regression testing is testing to find out if unwanted defects have been created in the change system. Regression testing is very important, because if the customer finds that what functionality or features were working previously are no longer working, so it will really make them angry. Just think back to the air conditioning example. All you wanted was that new air conditioning system is fitted in your house, but after fitting the air conditioning system, you find that the lights which were working previously are not working. So you'll definitely complain about it. In the email example, earlier you were able to send emails without attachments, but after the attachment feature is implemented, you are no longer able to send any email at all. So customers are more tolerant with new feature not working, and they're less tolerant with regression issues. Now the next question is, when should you do regression testing? Now some testers leave regression testing to the very end within system testing, and that is the time when they do regression testing, but ideally regression testing should be done in all the levels. So regression testing should be done at the unit testing level, integration testing level, and the system testing level. The reason is that the focus of testing is different in the multiple levels. It is more efficient to find regression defects this way instead of just bundling all the regression testing within the system testing level. Which test cases do you execute in regression testing? Well, before you select the test cases that you execute in regression testing, you have to find out the impact of changes to the system, because regression is only possible in areas which have changed. So first of all, find out the impact of changes to the system, then select only test cases that cover the impacted components of the system. That is because time is key, and you want basically to have the minimum set of test cases that cover all the impacted components of the system. The next question is, how frequently should you run the regression test? Now, ideally, regression test should be done every time there is any system change, but at least one complete regression test should be done before system deployment to production, or before you hand over the system to the customer. Which part of the regression test should be automated? Actually, regression tests have automation candidates. So tests which are stable, they are repeated frequently, they are simple and require no tester input, no tester manual input, are good candidates for test automation. And that is how you can reduce the overall effort in the regression test. How do you ensure that your regression tests are effective? Time is always a key in testing. So first of all, the regression test should be wide enough to allow catching defects. If it is a very narrow test which just tests a very small part of the system, it is possible that it will not be able to bring up the regression defects. And also the regression test should be detailed enough to allow catching the defects. If it is just a very high level or superficial kind of a test, it is possible that regression issues are not caught with those tests. So the regression test should be wide enough and detailed enough to allow catching the defects. Also, in your entire regression test suite, that is the set of the regression test cases that you have selected, you can eliminate the duplicate test cases or merge test cases which have common parts, and also automate the tests as far as possible. So that is about regression testing, and regression testing is a very important test, because what features and attributes of the system are already working, the customer is very much concerned about those, and they should continue to be working. So regression testing is very important so that the existing system functionality and the existing system quality attributes are maintained. Thank you, and see you in the next video.